Hi, I'm Leslie Martin with Dwellings by Rudy and Hall. In this episode, I'm going to be talking about an important issue many of my clients have experienced. And that is what to do when you are in a multiple offer situation. So every seller wants to get multiple offers on their house when it's on the market. It can be a little difficult to navigate if you're not prepared on how you're going to answer all of these offers. So let's say you have three offers come in on your home. What do you do? Well, option number one is to pick one of those offers and negotiate with them and just reject the other two. Option number two is to give a multiple counteroffer to all three parties. And that means they know that there are other offers on the table and you give them the same counteroffer, the same price, the same terms, everything. And you see what happens. The third option is to give a counteroffer to all three parties that are different. Maybe you can give certain terms to this one or a different price to that one. You can do whatever you want and you can negotiate separately with all three parties. Another option that has been in play a lot recently in multiple offer situations is what's known as calling for highest and best. What this does is it signals to the buyer's agents that the seller is about to make a decision on all these offers. So if you want to offer some more money or better terms to ensure that you're picked, now's the time. While it's a bit risky when it comes to mortgages being dependent on appraisals, it can boost the selling price. Now, everyone thinks whoever gives me the most money is who I pick. Yes, that is top criteria. And when polled, most sellers say that they just want the most money. But there are other factors that could make a difference, like if there's any contingencies on their purchase or if one's party's financing is better than someone else's, or if someone is all in at a cash offer. You never know what you're going to do until you get that offer in hand. So hopefully this will help you address that multiple counter offer situation. If you have any questions about this, you can always give me a call, send me an email. If you're watching this on Facebook, be sure to give it a like, leave me a comment, tag someone who you think will find value in this, and share it. If you're watching this on my YouTube channel, make sure you give it a like, share it, and leave a comment including the time code if you found something really good. Thanks for watching this episode of Wednesday Wisdom. I'm Leslie Martin, and I'll see you next time.